Hello and welcome to Lesson 3 of the Articy Draft Importer for Unity tutorial series. In the last episode, we added the Articy Flow Player component to our Dialog Manager and worked on both Player Controller and Dialog Manager scripts to create the basic functionality with which we can access Articy data in our Unity game project. When playing through the scene, we can now interact with an NPC to display the first line of a dialog reference to this object. In this lesson, we will refactor some code in the Player Controller script to tweak and improve some functionality, and secondly, add the speaker name to the dialog UI. If you are following this tutorial series via YouTube, you find links to blog posts for the corresponding lessons in the video description. In these blog posts, you can find all code snippets discussed in the lesson. The Player Controller script works, but I'm not entirely happy with the way it is set up currently. I'd like to use the Articy object, which we use to pass the dialog to start dialog, to also make the check if the player is able to initiate a conversation. I will rename Articy object to availableDialogue to make this double usage clearer. I click the variable name and then press F2 to rename it throughout the script. Again, this is for Visual Studio 2019 on PC. Your IDE might have different hotkeys. In the player interaction method, we now have to update the if statement from isNearNPC to availableDialogue. Then we can remove isNearNPC from the declaration area and the onTriggerEnter and exit methods. I will save the script and do a quick test in Unity if everything still works as expected. When I press the spacebar here, nothing happens. When pressing space near the green NPC, our dialog UI opens like it is supposed to. And we even have an improvement in that nothing happens when we press space near the red NPC. It has no dialog referenced yet, and therefore it is absolutely correct that the dialog UI is not activated here. Before, we checked only if the player was in the vicinity of an NPC object, not if this object had something to say or not. Nice, we got rid of an unnecessary variable and improved the functionality with this small refactoring. While we are here in Unity, we can also delete the dialog holder script, as it will no longer be used anywhere in this project. I'd like to do another tweak to the player controller though. It works fine for the current situation, but if we start to include trigger elements without an Articy reference, we run into problems. If I remove the Articy reference from NPC2 and test it, we get a null reference exception as soon as we enter the object's trigger zone. To fix this, we need to add a check to the onTriggerEnter method in the player controller script. I start by declaring a variable Articy reference component and initialize it to the Articy reference component of the object that caused the trigger event. Then we create an if statement to check if this component was found. If there is an Articy reference on the object, we assign availableDialogue the value of this object reference. This replaces the assignment we did previously for the availableDialogue variable. That takes care of our null reference exception from before, but we need to take one more step. As of right now, we still have the situation that if we interact with NPC1, or even just move through its trigger zone and then interact with NPC2, the dialog is also shown for NPC2, which is not what we want. We can take care of this issue with another if statement in onTriggerExit. We check if the Articy reference component of our triggering object is not equal to null. If this is the case, we set availableDialogue to null. If we enter a trigger zone and an Articy reference exists, we fetch it. If we leave the trigger zone and there is a reference, it gets cleared. That's it. Works like a charm. And before I forget, I will revert to component removal on my MPC2 object to have the Articy reference in place when we need it later on. In our dialog UI, we have already planned to display the speaker name. Let's take care of that now. We already have this information, we only need to access it. This we will do in the onFlowPlayerPaused method in the Dialog Manager C# script. First, we want to find out if the object has a speaker property and try to fetch it. We do this by declaring a variable object with speaker and initializing it to a object cast to I object with speaker. With a object, we access the same argument passed into the method as for the dialog text, but we cast it into a different interface to access different parts of object's data without making assumptions about its exact type. Now we add an if statement to check if object with speaker is not equal to null. If the object has a speaker property, we'll fetch the reference and cast it to an entity to be able to access its display name. For that, we declare a second variable, speakerEntity, and initialize it to objectWithSpeaker.Speaker, cast to entity. We have some squiggly lines beneath entity, and AltEnter shows that we are missing a namespace. Don't be confused by the name of this namespace, it is derived from the name of your Articy project. Now we are going to add another check. If the speakerEntity is not equal to null, then we assign dialog speaker.text the value of speakerEntity.displayName. And same as before with the dialog text, we also want to make sure not to display the same speaker multiple times as a potential issue when an object contains no speaker. And to that end, we set dialog speaker.text to an empty string at the top of the method. Let's save our script and switch to Unity to run a quick test. And voila, we now can see that Kyrian is the speaker for this line of dialogue. This will be all for this lesson. We refactored some code in the player controller script, with the result that we got rid of an unnecessary variable and even improved the functionality of the onTriggerEnter method overall. And secondly, we implemented displaying the speaker name in our dialog UI. In the next lesson, we will add functionality to the buttons of our dialog UI, so that we can finally traverse through the entire linear test dialog. See you there!